The recently defeated Wildlife Act legislation was an act that was creating deep cultural divides based on race, and if passed, could have spelled the end of mineral exploration and development in the north, as well as killed off or seriously hurt our tourism industry because of the many flaws in the drafting of the document. What is your position on the Wildlife Act, and what are you committed to do to ensure fair representation for all Northerners and industry in any future attempt at producing the Wildlife Act? And we'll begin with Glenn Abernathy of Great Slave Lake.
Thank you. This is almost exactly the same question that was asked at the last forum, and I'm going to answer it in pretty much exactly the same way. There's no question that the NWT needs to update and revise its Wildlife Act. Its current Wildlife Act is incredibly outdated. The problem is that when the government came forward with this act this time, they did rush the process. There's no doubt in my mind. Often you hear individuals saying, we've been working on this for 16 years, 20 years. But bottom line is the act would be worked on, then it would go into a closet for a while, then it get worked on and go back into a closet. The most recent act came out and was pushed immediately after the Species at Risk Act passed, and it's my understanding that they wanted to get it through in the life of the last assembly. So they brought it out. The most recent draft of the draft that they brought out was in November, and they gave people in the Northwest Territories 45 days. 45 days to look at this act, and they didn't give enough people the opportunity to really dig into an act that has this kind of significance to the people of the Northwest Territories. It got defeated, thank God. But it does need to come back. I mean, it needs to go out to the people of the Northwest Territories for thorough discussion. We need to make sure that all interest groups have an opportunity to spend the time they need to dig into this act. It's a complex act, and people need time. As it comes forward in the 17th Assembly, I'm committed to making sure that a real consultation process is conducted on the Wildlife Act before it comes before the legislature again.
Thank you. And our second candidate for Great Slave Lake, Pat Scott.
Revisions to the Wildlife Act will happen, and I completely agree with Glenn. They need to be done in full consultation, not in a slipshod way, as they were done or attempted to be done in the last assembly. But we have a problem. We have to recognize that there are constitutional and Aboriginal rights that provide certain harvesting benefits to Aboriginal people. That has to be recognized and dealt with during the consultation. We also know that we have resident hunters and big game outfitters who have economic interests that need to be addressed as well. So we have to find that balance between the constitutional and legal rights of the Aboriginal people who are negotiating agreements that the government of the Northwest Territories has to, is signing on to, and it's already signed on in the case of the Tsleil-Waututh, the Gwich'in, and Saulteaux. They have to respect the laws that they've already signed. The whole revision of the Act needs to be based on conservation and a balance between harvesting rights and conservation. The species need to survive, as the elders, Denny elders say, for seven generations. We need to plan that far ahead. And I'm coming.
Thank you.